Have you ever wondered about obelisks? I do. Hey y'all, I'm James Wright, and welcome to my shop. Today, I voted. Did you? That's about as political as I get on this channel, so yeah, let's get under the work. This last week, I did put out two new videos. One of them was cutting a stop dado. In the past, I've shown how to cut a through dado, and I wanted to say, okay, what do you do if you stop? And that's one of those points where hand tools really kind of shine because there isn't a great way of doing it with power tools. So feel free to go check out that video. The second video for the week was on work holding. I didn't go into a lot of the passive methods of work holding, like using stops and holds on your bench top. I was more looking at the hold fast and the vices and how those work and what are some of the differences in them. So if you're ever looking at what type of vice should I get, what are the pros and cons of them, feel free to check out that video. It has a lot of information along that line. Also this week, I went to the Midwest Tool Collectors Association meet in Southern Illinois, and that was a lot of fun. I was able to purchase a few things. Number one, a little spoke shave, an old wooden style, and I actually want to make a couple of these. A new friend of mine, Tom Shirley, sent me two of these blades that he had, and so I'm going to be actually making one of these. I'm going to be making two of them and sending one back to him, and I'm thinking about giving away the other one. So there should be a video on how to make your own spoke shave coming out soon. Also at the meet, I purchased two new hand planes. Well, two to me. They are Stanley. This is a Type 13 corrugated number 6, and then a Type 7 number 8. I've been wanting a number 8 and a number 6 for a while and never had them quite come into my price range. Had the chance to purchase these and jumped at it. So this last week I ended up actually restoring 5 other hand planes, and then I get these to restore, so I constantly have a pile that I need to restore. But I'm going to wait on these and do these ones a little bit later. Speaking of that, the next couple weeks I'm going to be having 3 different videos coming out on restoring hand planes. With the 5 that I recently restored, I cataloged those into 3 different types. Number one, the cheap hand planes that you're not looking to make them look pretty, you just want to make them work and want to make them work fast. What do you need to do for that? So I went through one video on that. I'll have another one on. I have a decent hand plane. I want it to look good, but I don't want to go through the whole thing of stripping it down completely and redoing it. And then the third video is I want to strip this down completely, redo it, new paint job, all the way down to the bare metal. And what do you want to do when you do that? So 3 of those videos should be coming out soon. And I've had a lot of people asking about those, so I'm looking forward to that. Another video soon coming up. I recently showed off my bar clamps with the wooden bar with the metal pieces, and Wildman Tech contacted me and said, hey, I can make those. So he sent me over these pieces that he is making for them, and I'm going to make the wooden handle grips to go on them, as well as the bars, and I'm going to send some to him. And then we're actually going to do a giveaway with these and give away a pair each. So you may have a chance to win those. So keep an eye out for that. I don't know when that video will be coming out, but it should be a fun one. Another thing I got to this last week was restoring these two handsaws for Wisely Michigan Woodworker. A new friend of mine, and I really had kind of fun doing these. They needed a lot of work, and they were kind of fun to put together. I don't have a video on those because I recently had a video on restoring saws. So if you want to see that, there's a link to the description. As some of you may have noticed, I am coming up on 10,000 subscribers and should be hitting that sometime around Thanksgiving, maybe a week or two after that. And so I'm kind of gearing up. I want to do a big giveaway. I'm going to be making a tool specifically. I'm not going to tell anyone about it until it comes. I'm going to be giving that away. But also I've been contacting a few other companies. Two Cherries is going to be giving up a set of chisels, a really cool set of chisels. Lee Nielsen is giving a $100 gift certificate to the prizes for this, which I think is phenomenal and going to be a great prize. And also Rockler is going to be offering a block plane. So I'm really looking forward to giving those. I've had a couple other YouTube channels contact me and possibly giving other prizes. There's a couple other companies who are thinking about it, and so I'm looking forward to that. If you would want to offer a prize into the giveaway, let me know. When I hit 10,000 subscribers, I'm going to put out that video and tell you how you can win one of these prizes. So the shout out for this week is A Guy Doing Stuff. I love the name of the channel, and the channel itself is great. Your video content is phenomenal. If you haven't seen his channel, he is currently building a wooden canoe out of cedar strips. Gorgeous, gorgeous work. He just finished putting the fiberglass on the outside and is about to flip it over. I am in love with this canoe, and does a lot of other very cool things. So definitely go check out his channel. There'll be a link in the description, and there should be one in the cards too. As part of reaching the newest level on Patreon, I'm answering one question a week from the patrons on Patreon. And if you haven't seen what I'm doing on there, feel free to go check out that. There's a link in the description below. But this question is from Doc Darkness, which you may have seen him commenting on many of my videos. He is a great supporter of the channel. And he asked, do you ever plan on purchasing a foot-powered lathe? And to be honest, no, I don't plan on purchasing one. I plan on building one. That is one of my projects. When the dresser is done, that's probably gonna be the next thing. I'm gonna be building a large flywheel that can then power a lathe. I also want to make it flexible so it can power a lathe, or it can power a scroll saw, or it can power a few other things I have in mind. So that's one of the projects coming up. But yes, I intend to do that. The question is, where do I put it? Because I really don't have space in the shop for that. So I may end up commandeering a part of the garage for that, but we'll see. So yeah, that should be kind of fun. Also this last week, the second episode from the Crafted podcast came out, and wow, I have been absolutely blown away by the response to this. ZH Fabrications and Crafted Workshop and I are doing this podcast called Crafted Workshop, where we're talking about all sorts of different materials and making things in general. And it's kind of fun to hear from different points of view how you would do things and what materials you'd work with and how you'd work with them. And so it's really becoming a fun podcast. And to that end, I have been absolutely blown away by the response. We are number one on the Hobbies Index for iTunes and a few others. And wow, I have been just blown away by how many people are actually watching or listening to this podcast. So the third issue of that will be coming out tomorrow. So if you're interested in that, go look at craftedpodcast.com or look it up on whatever app you use to listen to podcasts. Also, we do it every Thursday at 7 p.m. Central Time or 8 p.m. Eastern Time. We record it live. And if you want to be a part of that, we actually get questions from the people who are watching it live and kind of get to be a part of the podcast. So if you want to listen to it live, you can do that at craftedpodcast.com/live. And there's links there where you can join the conversation. So looking forward to hearing from you and being a part of the podcast. So as you can tell, there is a crazy amount going on in the shop this week. That's why I haven't gotten to the dresser. I'm hoping to hit the dresser and finish up the carcass this next week, but we will see how that comes out. Yeah, you know how that works. If you have any questions, please let me know in the comments below. If you have any ideas for future videos, I would love to hear them. I do want to say a huge thank you to the patrons on Patreon. You guys are phenomenal and have been a great encouragement to me. If you have any questions you'd like me to answer, let me know, and I would love to put those on here. If you did like this video, feel free to check out one of my others. You might find something you like there. And until next time, have a wonderful day.